In 1905, a patent clerk published his science paper, which changed the science and perspective of the whole world. He elegantly explained how space and time are interrelated and gave us amazing insights about moving at the speed of light. It introduced us to the cosmic speed of light of an object. What happens if we travel at the speed of light? The theory of special relativity explains how space and time are linked for the objects moving at a constant velocity. This constant velocity is also the main difference between special and general relativity. When we talk about special relativity, we take into account the objects moving with constant velocity. For example, a car moving on a straight road with a constant velocity, whereas in general relativity, we talk about motion, which is not constant velocity motion. Motion in which the observer could be speeding up or slowing down or going around a bend, which we call the accelerated motion and also known as generalized motion, like motion of planets or any other general motion. The move from constant velocity motion to accelerated motion, it turns out, brings in an understanding of force of gravity. Einstein realized that by including generalized motion that would include accelerated motion, he could get an understanding of the force of gravity in terms of warps and curves. We already discussed about general relativity in one of our videos, and you can go and learn more about it. Now let's talk about some very important corollaries of special relativity. One of the most famous equations in physics comes from special relativity. The equation E equals mc squared means energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. It shows that energy and mass are interchangeable. They are different forms of the same thing. If mass is somehow converted into energy, it shows how much energy would reside inside that mass. Quite a lot. This equation is one of the demonstrations for why an atomic bomb is so powerful once its mass is converted into energy or an explosion. This equation also shows that mass increases with speed, which effectively put a speed limit on how fast things can move in the universe. Simply, we can say that the speed of light is the fastest velocity at which any object can travel. As an object moves, its mass also increases. Near the speed of light, the mass is so high that it reaches infinity, and would require infinite energy to move, as we have discussed earlier, thus capping how fast an object can move. You all might think that's how light travels at that speed. The only reason why light moves at this speed is because it consists of photons, which have a rest mass of zero. As an object approaches the speed of light, its mass becomes infinite, and also the body contracts in the direction of motion. This cosmic speed limit has been a subject of much discussion in physics, and also in science fiction, as people think how to travel through vast distances. In fact, Einstein realized that the answer is both space contracts and time dilates or slows. Why? If I'm sitting in my room on my study table, you would say that I'm not moving, but in fact I am moving, just not through space but time. Time and space are interchangeable, or we can say they are two sides of a coin. So when we move through space, some of the motion can be thought of as being diverted into motion through time, and vice versa. In much the same way as a car traveling northwest diverts some of its northwards motion towards west. Space and time are interrelated, somewhat like x and y axis, as shown in figure below. The only difference is that we cannot move only through space. We move through time also. We always move through time. When we are at rest, we move only through time, but when we move through space also, some of our motion through time is diverted towards space, and so the time is less than that it should be, or we can say time is dilated. Thus, the dimension of space and time affect each other, and both space and time are thus relative concepts. This revolutionary idea also helps in better understanding of simultaneity, but we will come to that later. So before we explore and understand the theory of special relativity, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel so that we can bring you more amazing science theories and videos. The concept of time dilation is one of the most fascinating ideas in physics. A strange conclusion from Einstein's work is that time moves relative to the observer. An object in motion experiences time dilation, meaning that time moves more slowly when one is moving than when one is at rest. Therefore, a person moving ages more slowly than the one at rest. We can simply say that moving clocks run slower than those at rest. How? Well, as I have explained above, that when we move through space, some of our motion is diverted from time to space, and time moves slower. For a person moving, time would move normally for him, but when observed from a different inertial frame, which is at rest, it would appear to be moving slowly. This becomes extremely apparent at speeds approaching the speed of light. Imagine a 15-year-old traveling at 99.5% the speed of light for 5 years, from his perspective. When he would get back to Earth, according to NASA, he would only be 20 years old. His twin on Earth, however, would be 65 years old. This is also called twin paradox. So an astronaut, Scott Kelly, spent nearly a year aboard the International Space Station in 2015-2016. His twin brother, Mark Kelly, aged a little faster than Scott. To some extent, you can say that the quicker or faster you go, the slower you age, and therefore the younger you are. The reason it's not noticeable in everyday life is that we move with velocity much smaller than the speed of light. The nearer the speed of an object approaches the speed of light, the more warped lengths and time intervals tend to become. While this time dilation sounds very theoretical, it does have practical applications as well. If you have a global positioning system or GPS receiver in your car, the receiver attempts to find signals from at least 3 satellites to coordinate your position. The GPS sends out timed radio signals that the receiver listens to, triangulating its position based on travel time of signals. The challenge is the atomic clocks on the GPS are moving and would therefore move slower and also move faster due to weaker gravity, because gravity also dilates time. We will discuss this aspect in general relativity. But overall, they move faster than clocks on Earth, creating timing issues. The clocks in our space are ticking faster because the GPS satellites are above Earth and experience weaker gravity. So even though the GPS satellites, which are always moving, experience a 7 microsecond of slowing every day because of their movement, the results of the weaker gravity causes clocks to tick quicker for about 45 microseconds faster than the ground-based clocks on Earth. So now when we add the 2 observations together, it leads to the GPS satellite clock ticking faster than a ground-based clock on Earth by about 38 microseconds every day. So engineers do have to make the clocks on a GPS tick slower. The amount of length contradiction and time dilation is given by the Lorenz factor. The Lorenz factor is given by this equation. The Lorenz factor, or Lorenz term, is the factor by which time, length, and relativistic mass change for an object while that object is moving. So if an object is moving with velocity c, we put its velocity in the equation, which gives us the factor of how much it will be affected by its velocity. When this velocity v is equal to c, we can clearly observe from the equation that y will approach infinity. So we can assume that traveling at the speed approaching the speed of light would hypothetically enable time travel into the future. As time slows down for the speeding object, in order to prevent the cosmic speed restriction of the speed of light. A corollary of all this is that if it were possible to exceed the speed of light, then we could go back in time. It is shown in the TV series The Flash. Although some scientists believe that some as of yet undiscovered laws of physics may intervene to prevent such paradoxes. Actually, special relativity does not forbid the existence of particles that can travel at speeds faster than light. And there's a theoretical subatomic particle known as tachyon, which might spend its life traveling faster than the speed of light. However, it's still hypothetical. Another corollary of the special relativity is simultaneity, or relativity of simultaneity. It states that one person's interval of space is not the same as another person's, and time runs at different speeds for different observers. Simply, you can say that if 2 events occur simultaneously in an inertial frame, then it is not necessary that they will occur simultaneously in another inertial frame. The idea that events that appear to happen at the same time for one person may happen at a different time for another person. The idea of space-time plays an important role in its understanding. We know space and time are interchangeable, and how. The idea becomes even more clearer when we consider that our picture of the moon is actually what the moon was like 1 to 1.4 seconds ago. The time light takes to reach the Earth from the Moon. Our picture of the Sun is actually how it looked 8.5 minutes ago. And by the time we see an image of Alpha Centauri, our nearest star system, it's already 4.3 years old. We can therefore never know what the universe is like at this particular time. and the universe is clearly not a thing that extends just in space, but in space-time. Therefore, we can say that time is experienced individually. There is no time, there are times. Due to the relativistic effects of the concept of time dilation, our idea and understanding of now is therefore something of an imaginary concept, one which we as humans have devised for ourselves, but for which nature itself has no real use. Physicists do not regard time as passing or flowing, and time is not a sequence of events which happen. The past, present, and future are just there, laid out as space-time. The twin paradox mentioned earlier is the perfect example for this. Therefore, as Einstein remarked, for us physicists, the distinction between past, present, and future is only an illusion, however persistent. Einstein's theory of relativity introduced us with some of the most important underlying theories of modern physics, which opened new doors of possibilities to explore for us. So what do you think about Einstein's special relativity? Which theory mentioned above could be said as the most important one? Let us know your questions and views in the comments section, and we will answer all your doubts. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to remain notified of more upcoming videos.